We're kicking off FURCA today. FURCA is the undergraduate Festival of Undergraduate Research and Creative Activities. Today we're kicking off the creative performances.
Hi everyone, thank you so much for having me. I'm gonna read you some poems today.
Feet trodden, blistered from prairie miles, following this treaty map, this delineation, this whispering, false knowledge of the contours of the grass.
My name is Catherine. I'm in my fourth year of a BA Combined Honors in English and History. I'm currently working on my thesis with the English department, and the work that I presented today was from a class I took with Dr. Christine Stewart and Knowledge Keeper Ruben Quinn called Write 494, A Poetics of Treaty. I would say for me, the biggest thing I learned while writing these poems is that both through the course and through writing the poem is what that actually means. That through the treaty, I have the right to live on this land, but then I also have certain responsibilities to the land and to the people whose land this is, the people whose traditional territories these are. And for me, it helped me to form a deeper relationship with the spaces I occupy and their geographies and the way that informs my identity.
Today is day two of FURCA. We've got oral presentations happening. We have two rooms of presenters who are given 20 minutes and they've got a PowerPoint and they'll be talking all about their research.
While capitalism has furthered our species' progress throughout time with innovation through competition, it is reaching its limits on this progress. Infinite growth doesn't work in a finite set of resources, and the Earth is finite. I'm doing the Certificate of Sustainability, and this was my last piece, my integrative project. I chose to look at fossil fuels and Marxism, mainly because it's something that I find personally is kind of my personal issue, the thing that I really care about.
We can see with waste in the world, a lot of this is failed objects. It's broken for some reason. It's unwanted. It doesn't work in the same capacity it's designed to work in, and then so it becomes garbage. I plan on putting some slides on the teleprompters around campus for sure. I might do a gateway article. I might do like an art installation around campus with the results that I get, because I'm 100% sure they're going to be really interesting. So yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Today is day three of FURCA. We have the poster symposium happening in CSIS. So we've got over 130 presenters. It's really cool that we have posters from students in arts and science that are right next to each other.
This year, we asked students to identify which of the 17 United Nations Sustainability Development Goals their project relates to get them thinking about how sustainability is relevant to their research.
My project is to design a process to recycle ethylene glycol airplane de-icer from the tarmac of airports in North America and collect it, purify it, and prepare it for reuse. I was naturally drawn to this project because of my interest in sustainability, and I thought that it would be a really good opportunity to use my chemical engineering background in a way that is inventive and not a typical usage of the degree.
Yeah, so I taught environmental sustainability policy to high school students, where we ended up like teaching about the carbon tax as a case study, presenting unbiased facts and information, creating safe spaces for students to talk about this policy and environmental policies in general.
So we created an app that helps inform users of like the recycling methods that are on campus. If you continue making bad mistakes, you'll get into the negatives. So we found that that's a good incentive for people to play again and to actually learn to where things go and how it's supposed to be done.
There's the issue that we are becoming more aware of is the issue of microplastics in my laundering process. So because this is such a loosely woven fleece garment, it's more prone to having more microplastics come off of it. A lot of times the recycled material is marketed as something good. And so I wanted to kind of challenge that idea of where is it actually sustainable? I wanted to question if it was sustainable to convert a plastic single-use item to yet another synthetic-based clothing garment.
So our main work was kind of a class project initially. As we looked more into the project, we really got into like the interdisciplinary nature of it and how it kind of melds healing for land and people.
A lot of connections can be made here,
And
that was kind of the exciting part of the project was, you know, we kind of came into it looking from a recreation perspective and then kind of found, oh, there's ecological connections, there's reconciliation in here, there's so many different ties, which was pretty exciting to kind of discover as we went along.
So for my project, I did a complete street audit. So what that is it's looking at the completeness of a street to meet all kinds of users. So I went to two streets in Jasper Avenue in Edmonton and Broadway in Vancouver and audited them on their completeness based on the complete street criteria. Complete streets are a great lens to improve the pedestrian experience because it's not only about safety, but it's also making the street a place pedestrians feel welcome and comfortable and want to spend time in, and therefore it has economic and social benefits as well.
So my project is about Indigenous food sovereignty in urban Canada. So basically there's this statistic that 33% of Aboriginal households compared to 9% of non-Aboriginal households are food insecure in Canada. So that means they don't have adequate access to safe, nutritious and healthy foods. I mean, 33% versus 9% is a huge divide. And when I was thinking about what I wanted to research, I've always had an interest in like sociology of food. So I was pretty set on that, but then I was thinking, what is the biggest food issue that faces Canada today? And to be honest, for me, like, this was it. Honestly, this has been a great experience. I was really nervous this morning, and then my friends all talked me down about it. And one of my friends who works with FURCA kind of told me, like, this is meant to be a celebration of your work. And that's what really hit home for me because, you know, this whole thing has been a learning process, and while undergraduate research doesn't always have like huge new findings, it's definitely a process that directs like how you want to live your life and do your research in the future, which has been like a really big thing for me.
I would just like to thank everyone who was involved in FURCA this year, from all the volunteers who helped us throughout the week. We could not have done it without everyone's help. I chose for the theme to be sustainability this year at FURCA, and we did this to get them thinking about how their projects relate to sustainability when otherwise they might not have thought about it. It was so cool on the day of to walk around and see like how different students' projects related to sustainability, and it ended up being such a cool and interesting week.